Super, super difficult to answer. That's why Saddle Fit for Life developed an 80 point of saddle fit. So what we do, we check all the points. And one of them is we want to see the horse on the launch line, if he's safe on the halter or bridle, without side reins, walk, trot, canter. See if the horse is just shaking his head, if he's a head shaker. Well, that's medical issue, right? So, but if we see the horse is very calm, he's licking, his ears are floppy, he's nice overstep, the tail is swinging, great. What we will do, I just remember, what we will do, we will show in one of our upcoming webinars how we do the dynamic fit. So I will comment on the online how we do dynamic fitting, and then I can really show, oh, that is coming from a saddle fitting. So back to the question, can it be from a saddle fit? Absolutely. Okay, so I go back to the area right here. So you see this in many books. This veterinarian, he calls himself Spinal Doctor. I met him in 2018. He talks about a lot about saddle fitting, and that's one of his document drawings here. You're looking at the cross-section of the withers. This spinalis muscle, okay? So that's a muscle what is super sensitive. So coincidental, a research paper just came out from the University of Zurich. Let me just show you the spinalis muscle here, okay, where it attaches. So if your saddle pinches on that area, of course the horses will pull the head up, okay? So the spinalis muscle is a muscle what is definitely, very sensitive. You know, so you don't want to push around there and want to cause all kinds of damage. So if I go back to the screen I had earlier, we want to look at another very sensitive muscle. Everybody talks about the trapezius muscle. Okay, the trapezius muscle. What about that? So let's find it. Here we go. The trapezius muscle you see here is very thin. Okay, also like your muscle, which is not a muscle what it's very tolerable to pressure, and it helps the scapula to move upwards, backwards. But when you look at my arrow in this picture where the horse has a dry spot, right above the dry spot on that area where my arrow right now is, a horse will rip and lift the head up if you go with your hand and just pinch. Use the same amount of force you would use to squish a grape or a lemon, okay? So you will see instantly the horse's head come up, all right? So this is a reflex point there, kind of like when somebody hits you below your kneecap, your leg goes forward. So if your saddle doesn't fit in the angle properly, okay? So let's say this is my hand is the wither cross section you see here on my screen. So when the spinalis contracts, okay, and the shoulder comes back, like I showed you in the movement, okay, you saw there's movement like this. Okay, I can't simulate that so good with two hands, I need four hands, so I'm just doing over one side. So this is the, I'm looking from the back of the horse, this is the right side of the horse, the withers is doing this. So pretend this is your saddle. Pretend the saddle is wrong in the angle, and this will not move. The saddle will come down and will pinch the wither cup. Again, the wither cup is right through here. The way you want to see your saddle sitting, look at this super, super longest, big fat muscle this here. This is the longissimus dorsi. That longissimus dorsi is the longest muscle, thickest muscle. So if the saddle sits here and there's no pinching of the withers, this can move. And the easiest way for you to test it, put your saddle on the horse, no saddle pad, no girth, no rider. Just put the saddle on. And then you take a pen, better as a pencil, right there where your D-ring is. See if your pencil goes easy underneath your D-ring. Just saddles it loose. Most of the saddles have no clearance. I call them the pencil clearance. They have no pencil clearance between the D-ring and the withers. I guarantee you, When you girth that saddle up, put a saddle pad on, put the rider on, the horse will do this. So back to the question. It definitely can cause by a wrong fitting saddle. Unfortunately, if I'm quoting a veterinarian from England, Sue Dyson, she has the highest citation of all equine journals. Very, very active in saddle research. And she claims that over 84% of all horses written show lameness. So we need to understand first, does there something else wrong than just the saddle? So that's why I recommend if you have a horse that throws a lot his head, launch the horse first, then comes the saddle on, bang, he throws his head. So we need to look at this. Does that come from the saddle? Does it come because I added additional weight? Here you see a thermography of a horse's back. The saddle doesn't fit properly in the front, super tight, no contact in the middle, and really digs in the loin, and the lumbar sacral joint has to compensate for this. So now when you put weight on the horse's back, you create all of a sudden a pinching in the hip or a pinching on the shoulder that wasn't there before. So most likely it comes from the saddle. If he shakes with the head and he doesn't shake, well, he shakes with the head with the saddle. If he doesn't shake with on the lunge line.